Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to the channel, and today I'm finally here for CD Collection Part 2. This time we're going to be doing B through D because I have a lot of albums from these letters of these bands. So, with that being said, let's going to get started. Okay, so up first for my B CDs is going to be Millennium by the Backstreet Boys. Yes, I like the Backstreet Boys. I think they're pretty good. Mostly, I'm more of a fan of their 90s and 2000s material. But, yeah, this is a really good album here. So, yeah, Millennium. I believe this came out in 1999. Some songs would be Larger Than Life, I Want It That Way, and some other songs. So yeah, Millennium, Backstreet Boys. Apologize about the glare there. It's my lamp, it's so bright and I don't have a shade for it, so for that I apologize. Alright, up next for my B's is going to be Expectations by Bebe Rexha, one of my favorite modern pop singers. Really good stuff on this album. Got songs like Ferrari, I'm a Mess, I Got You, Self Control, Sad. Of course, the overrated song Meant to Be with Florida Georgia Line. So yeah, Bebe Rexha and her debut album, Expectations. Really good stuff there from her. Alright, the next two albums are both by the same singer. So Britney Spears and her album Femme Fatale, and the deluxe edition of her album Glory. So yeah, pretty good stuff there. Next three albums are from one of the most legendary metal bands of all time. So we're finally on the metal and rock side of things here. So Black Sabbath and their album Paranoid, really good stuff there. A lot of these albums I'm just gonna have to rush to because I have so many. Master of Reality, Black Sabbath. My favorite Black Sabbath album, Sabbath Bloody Sabbath. Especially this next band, I'm just gonna have to rush through there, especially because I have way too many. So guys, this is gonna just be rushed through, right through, because this band has way too many albums for. The band, of course, is Bon Jovi, Slippery When Wet, Special Edition of New Jersey, Keep the Faith, their Greatest Hits album, Crossroad, or whatever you want to call it, These Days by Bon Jovi, Crush, Bon Jovi, Bon Jovi's album Bounce, Lost Highway, Bon Jovi, The Circle by Bon Jovi, the two-disc version of their 2010 Greatest Hits album, and last for Bon Jovi, the deluxe edition of This House Is Not For Sale. So that's gonna complete all of my Bon Jovi's here. So one more for stack one. And last for stack one is going to be the new Born of Osiris album, Angel or Alien. So that's going to complete all of stack one. Like I said, I had to rush through Bon Jovi because I have so many of their albums. So certain bands, when I do these collection videos, I'm just going to have to rush through because I have way too much of their albums. So next band, I only have two albums from, one studio album and one greatest hits or whatever. So up first for Breaking Benjamin is going to be Shallow Bay. The Best of Breaking Benjamin. Breaking Benjamin, Dark Before Dawn. Pretty good album there. So I need to move these over a little bit so none of them fall. Next band is another band I have a lot of albums from, so I'm just going to rush right through. The band is Bullet For My Valentine and their album The Poison. My favorite Bullet For My Valentine album, Screaming Fire. Really great metalcore there, definitely recommend it. Fever, Bullet For My Valentine. Temper, Temper by Bullet For My Valentine. Overhated album, doesn't deserve the hate that it gets. Venom, Bullet For My Valentine. And of course, their worst album by far, Gravity. Definitely a regret purchase there with Gravity. I do not like the album, it's way too watered down. And it doesn't even sound anything like Bullet For My Valentine. How bad it is. Okay, this next band I only have one album from, and the band of course is Cannibal Corpse. This is their newest album, Violence Unimagined. Pretty good stuff there. Not the biggest death metal fan, but I like some death metal bands. Okay, up next is Lotus or Lotus by Christina Aguilera. This is the deluxe edition. Got some extra songs there, so it's pretty awesome. Not one of her best albums, but still okay for what it is. Next band I have two albums from. Definitely rest in peace to their lead vocalist, Alexi. And of course, the band is Children of Bodom. Hate Crew Death Roll, really good stuff there. And their final album, Hexed, good stuff there as well. Next band, Chimera, their album, The Infection. Had to read the site because it's not even listed anywhere on the album cover. I don't like when bands do that, but it's whatever. Next two albums are from the same band, and the band is Death Angel. This is their album, The Evil Divide, but this is the Digipak version because it comes with the CD, of course, tattoo, and the booklet. Always kept a tattoo because I didn't want to put it on my arm or anything because I thought it'd just be cool to keep in the case. Also for Death Angel is their album, Humanicide. Definitely can't wait to hear more from Death Angel. Really great thrash metal there. Sorry guys, I had to move these third and fourth stacks over a bit. Next band, I have all of their discography, well, studio album wise, because I don't really collect EPs or live albums or anything like that. More of a studio guy. So this band also gonna have the rush to their albums. I have all of their albums, and the band is Demon Hunter, their self-titled debut album. Great album. If you're a fan of nu metal and groove metal and metalcore, check it out, because it's definitely one of those influenced albums. Okay, Demon Hunter, Son of Darkness, The Triptych by Demon Hunter, Demon Hunter's album Storm the Gates of Hell, special edition, my favorite Demon Hunter album. I think it's kind of underrated, great album though. Demon Hunter, The World is a Thorn, one of their weaker albums, but it's still very good for what it is. Demon Hunter, True Defiance. Demon Hunter, Extremist. Demon Hunter, Outlive. Demon Hunter, War. And last for Demon Hunter is their album, Peace. Probably won't be buying their acoustic album because I'm not a fan of acoustic albums, but I will check out that album sometime though on a streaming service platform. Okay, continuing with the D's is going to be the only album from this band, and the band is Device. This was a side project for David Draiman from Disturbed. Really good stuff there. Next band I only have one album from, and the band is The Devil Wears Prada. This is their debut album, Dear Love, A Beautiful Discord. Don't really go back to that album that much, but I still thought it'd be pretty cool to have it in the collection because I do like the band's over stuff. Okay, next band I have three albums from, and the band is Devil Driver. This is like a digipack version of their album Winter Kills. I recently reviewed this album on the channel, so please check it out. So yeah, Winter Kills by Devil Driver. Not their best album, but it's still okay for what it is. Devil Driver, Trust No One, bonus tracks version. And I know it's kind of slit right here, but it's like that when I bought it in the mail, or got it in the mail about 3 or so years ago, or something like that. And last for Devil Driver for now, Dealing with Demons, Volume 1. Another album that's not one of their best, but still okay for what it is. Okay, guys. I believe we're following the last stack now. Sorry guys, I had to rush through this, but it's okay. Next for my D's is going to be Dio and their album Master of the Moon. This is a bonus disc version, so pretty awesome. Really good stuff there. Definitely a good album. Next band, big fan of this band. They're the band that got me into metal, or at least one of the bands that got me into metal. And of course, the band is going to be Disturbed, the album The Sickness, great stuff. Disturbed, their album Believe. Disturbed, 10,000 Fists, my favorite Disturbed album, love it, great album. Disturbed, Indestructible, Asylum by Disturbed. Disturbed's album, Lost Children, well, compilation album of B-sides. Really good stuff there. A lot of underrated stuff. Disturbed, Immortalized, stuff here. Last for Disturbed, the deluxe edition of Evolution, their weakest album, but doesn't deserve the hate that it gets. And last for my D's, well, I got two more bands, my bad. So, this next band I have three albums from, and I'm starting to get into this band more because they are one of the most legendary prog metal bands of all time, and the band is Dream Theater, and this is Images and Words. So far, my favorite Dream Theater album. I really like that one. Really great stuff there. Awake by Dream Theater. Heard good things about that album. And last for Dream Theater, Systematic Chaos. So yeah, I definitely need more of their albums. And I think this next album is going to be the last album for my B through D's. And the album is Sinner by Drowning Pool. I think this is their best album. Definitely rest in peace to the original lead vocalist of Drowning Pool, Dave Williams. He passed away way too young back in 2002. About a year after the album Sinner came out, because that album came out in 2001. But yeah, guys, with that being said, I hope you guys enjoyed CD Collection Part 2. And I apologize about that background noise. That is my significant other. She just has a tendency of snoring really loud in her sleep. So I hope that's not too much of a distraction for you guys. But yeah, with that being said though, I hope you guys enjoyed the CD Collection Part 2 video. And I know it was a lot shorter than Part 1. I just had so many albums here that I had to rush through them because I didn't have much time to record it. But yeah, with that being said though, y'all, I hope you guys enjoyed it. And yeah, I'll see y'all next time. Peace.